Hello, my lovely Twitch chat. Hello, it is I, your not-so-favorite, not-so-say-city-dinner anime cat girl, and,
I'm not a furry.
And I bet y'all are wondering, Yui,
what the fuck are you playing?
Well, listen, I saw this game on Steam. It's called Furry Shakespeare, To Date or Not To Date Cat Girls. And I like cat girls, but only when they're humanoid like me. With some rare exceptions here and there. Anyway, yeah. Listen, I'm not a furry, but I decided to play this game because why the fuck not? This company has, like, other games of, like, Furry Shakespeare. Like, they have a scaly version of this game. They have, like, other, like, Furry Shakespeare games. But I'm only going to be focusing on the this version. To date or not to date cat girls. Alright, let's actually play the game. The big deal is that video games are going to have more character, but you're not going to have a plot that says, you know. It's not going to be Shakespeare. Okay. Steven Spielberg. There's no way he said that. Upon the streets of Elsinore do we begin in the wealthy country of Arden. Wow, lots of lore. Who the fuck's Robin Puck? Is it like Robin Hood? Hath been the 3 years and 3 months since the War of the Roses ravaged the natural beauty of this land and its people. Scars run deep. Elsinore Academy, a college university built with the intention of teaching future royalty, has since become a refuge for war orphans. This has been a widely contested political act for King Claudius. Yo, are we doing a prologue or are we drinking? Oh, okay, so they do talk modern talk. Good. Good. Alright, so I guess one of the dragon dudes is Othello, and that's Robin, I guess. Robin's kind of cute. Is she supposed to be a skunk? She looks like a skunk, or is she just a cat girl? I can barely tell. The Elsinore Tigers have won their annual homecoming game, and as such are in jovial spirits. That's such a yes for the prologue. Oh, and I guess we have another girl named Miranda. She looks kind of cute. Not a furry, but I'll be there in a minute. Hey yo, another dragon! To kicking Verona University scaly hides. Here, here! I'm gonna get us a table. Oh, his name's Macbeth. Just like the character from the Shakespeare play. Though, isn't like saying Macbeth's name kind of a curse? Or at least only like a curse on stage? I don't know, I'll have to Google it. Is that a human? That's a human. Why is there a human in a furry dating game? I have no idea. But I hope I can date her because she's the only human it looks like. Now we're all 21 here, right? I can probably do some magic to change everyone's ID. A place in the back is opening up for us. You're going to use actual real magic to change an ID? That's such amazing overkill. Do we? Hello, Kate? She's a beaver. I think everyone here is good, Vi. I'm still not over the fact that you wanted to use actual magic to change an ID, something that you can do at home. Ganymede? 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 I don't know how to pronounce his name, I'm just gonna call him Gan for now. Wait, do you mean change our identities or our IDs? Viola, don't. I was only thinking about it as I'm thinking about it, but not doing it. To Macbeth, whose field goal kick-turned everything around. First round of drinks are on him. Hardy har har. Hey. Heard about Desdemona, man. Tough break. Women, you know. Hey! What's that about women? I know you're better than that joke. Yeah, exactly. It's 2022. We don't make those jokes anymore. Except as in a joke. I don't know, man. We were so good before the war, and then for a while at Elsinore Academy, we were good. Then we weren't. No use dwelling on the past or people's intentions. Tonight is a new night. Until we forget it. It's a school night. Can't get too wasted. I mean, usually I'd agree with that, but then again, I got turnt yesterday with everybody when I was playing Monster Prom with them, so I would have no room to talk. Every night is a school night. Every night is pressure up the insane amount of, well, pressure. That Elsinore place is upon us. All of us. This country is a meat grinder. Some, like myself, just know how to play the game. I know how to play football for them. That is my part of the game. We just won homecoming, dude. Let's just get shit-faced. Hell yeah! Get shit-faced! To the moral victors, we... Show those people. Hey, let's get you to your room. Oh, is that me? I guess that's me. But the people, they must know. We can take him from here, hero. You sure? We won tonight's game. Did you see that, Miranda? Yeah, I saw. We all saw. You're a hero. No, no, you see, hero's name is Hero. Oh, that's funny. Very, very clever. That's funny. My name's Othello. Othello. Thanks, Miranda. Thanks, Macbeth. See you tomorrow at senior class sign-up. It's like Jell-O. He's shit-faced. He's drunk. Another year at good old Elsinore Academy. Can hardly wait. I really can. But did anyone see us win tonight's game? I need to know this information. Yes, everyone saw the homecoming game, Othello. Okay, buddy, let's get you to bed. Night, hero. You drifted off to Slumberland, awaiting as well as dreading your final year. Both feelings battle for dominance in your belly. Oh, is that a Shakespeare? Oh, it's Hamlet. Act 1. Not a tutorial. Thank you. I hope for your sake that this year goes well for you, hockey puck. Cat boy! There's a cat puck! There's a cat boy! Hell yeah, we get a cat boy. Hopefully I can date him. Thank you? That's not the threat you were looking for, Tybalt. Don't tell me what is and what is not an inappropriate insult, hockey puck. You may be fae, but humans still rule the school. And I'm human prime, so I rule the hell out of the school. You're still a cat boy. Wow, this game is casual racism. You love to see it. Hey, run along now. Daddy's coming to solve all your weedle problems. It's only the beginning of the year, Tybalt. We have a full 365 days to start something. Don't you want to go and pick and choose? Oh, Tybalt, is this a lover's spat? I can whip up a nice little love potion to set things right. I don't like guys. My masculinity is intact. He totally likes guys. I thought I stopped doing witchcraft. Well, I did, sort of. I'm still a word sister. That's just in my DNA, but I'm trying to get better. Elsinore Academy has a strong tradition of cheerleader witches. You know that? It's hard to buck history. Especially when the country relies on a steady stream of mages to fuel their wars, right? I'm against that sort of thing, and we're not all bad. Remember, you used to be one of us. Well, I'm not anymore. She'll come around, Viola. I just want my best friend back. That's up to her, V. I mean, I wish this game would be better if they had more character-like models. Cause it's kind of hard to like read the dialogue with everyone like having like the same expression. But I guess Viola and Miranda used to be friends or something. Here, can you believe it? We're seniors. I know it's rather insane. I'm just gonna like have them call me Yui instead of Hero. I wish I could change my name, but I can't. So I'm just gonna say Yui instead of Hero. I'm one step closer to becoming a president's wife and then controlling everything behind the scenes. I love the way you think, Viola. Didn't I just hear you tell Miranda that not all witches use their powers for evil? But I'd be good at it, really not being evil. Yo, Bethany, what classes did you pick? Can you please stop calling me Bethany? What if I walked around calling you a penniless whore? Oh, damn! Ah, I see you picked Asshole 101. Come on, your dick isn't going to fall off just because I called you by the root of your name. Macbeth was a famous Scottish queen. I know. My mother always reminds me that that she wanted a girl. Is that why your head is constantly up to your neck doing the Elsinore salute? You know, speaking of root definitions, the Elsinore salute isn't actually a salute to troops or authority at all. It was co-opted by the dirt-poor portion of the population or the mocked supposedly peaceful monarchy. Do not mock the military, Kate. It will not end up well for you. Especially if you end up in America. Eh, sure. Mac, Yui, what'd you pick? A mix of everything, really. I'm in theater again. Well, I picked Theater of the People more specifically. Awesome, me too. Oh, shocker of the century. That is unexpected for you to take a theater class. Who could have predicted such an outcome? Macbeth, you bore me. I'm sorry for this inconvenience. I'm gonna have enough fun this year for the both of us. Did you really have to be so mean just then? Kate's enthusiasm for everything gets on my nerves sometimes, okay? So all the time. Still, the jab at her finances was a bit rude. Oh, please. Kate still goes here. Her family isn't hurting for shit. Everyone take your seats. The assembly will begin shortly. As you know, today marks two anniversaries. One, the end of the War of Roses. The other, the attempt on my life by my own niece and Arden's own prince heirs, the prince and Princess Hamlet. Oh, he's a manticore. I was like wondering, why does this guy have like, is like a line with like bat wings, but I think he might be a manticore. You had Prince Hamlet killed. He tried to assassinate your king, your leader. Who knows what foul lies our enemies had told him. Arden is corrupt. We are still trying to locate the treasonous Princess Hamlet, but she seems to have escaped into thin air, as if she left the universe completely. Huh, how convenient. All eyes look to Miranda. She bites her tongue and just flips King Claudius off. Jesus Christ, Miranda. I love a woman who isn't afraid of authority. We love that here. As we all know, Hamlet's reign of terror had many victims. My wife died of a broken heart. Prince Hamlet and his sister would oft speak with many of you, but none was as loved and dearly as Ophelia Nightingale. Here we go. Ophelia was the fair flower of this kingdom, and many thought that she would be the next queen, as she and Prince Hamlet were in love. At last, she too was driven mad, and one night fell into the lake, drunk and helpless. And a threat. But now we fight back our tears to celebrate the future of our kingdom. Whatever that shit may look like. Moving on, I'd like to give jovial explanation to Othello Moore and Macbeth Dale, who led our Elsinore Tigers to victory against the Verona Sandpipers in last night's football game. It was no big deal. We fought together, our enemies in war. Verona thought valiantly. They were a worthy opponent. Just not worthy enough. Now, let me extend jovial exclamation to the incoming senior class. In years' time, you shall be thrust into the world groomed to be heirs to royalty, groomed to be advisors to royalty, groomed to be better. He can go on and on like this for a while. You want to get out of here? Sure. God, I really am not looking forward to the hustle and hormones that a new year brings. The hustle? I guess it's time to give you a refresher on how this school works. Everything runs on the currency of reputation. Athletics, knowledge, intelligence, personality. Oh. They're all ones. These are your stats. They represent how many things you know and or are good at. Each class period, you have the chance to up one of them. During breaks or after school, you have the opportunity to level up your status with one or more classmates by impressing them with the skills that you have acquired. This can help when either asking for favors or asking someone to a dance or whatnot. Okay, so looks like I can date Robin, Othello, Miranda, Gan, Kate, Viola, or, ooh, Macbeth. I think I'm gonna go for Miranda. She's really sassy and I like her. You've also got your schedule. This doesn't just show you your current or upcoming classes, but also can be used for seeing what upcoming events are going on after school, so you can properly prepare. You know, when the dances are, the sports ball games, and the like. Yeah, I got my classes already. So what are you good in? What are your initial skills that you bring to the table that can help jumpstart your journey to senior year? I'm not really sure. I've always been sort of a jack-of-all-trades, I guess. All right, what did I got? Math in senior year, I barely passed because I was taking pre-calc. Theater, last theater class I took was in junior year of high school. I did pretty good on that. I think I got an A in that class. Music. Last music class would be, I think, freshman choir. I did pretty good at that. History, if that's like social studies, then I guess the last thing I took would be American history in my junior year of high school. But I think like actual history was 10th grade of high school, and I barely passed. PE, last PE class I took was freshman year of high school. I did what I could, I think. I think I did okay with that. Engineering. Last time I took an engineering class was middle school. 8th grade middle school. And, again, I did alright. I barely passed, though. Like, I mean, it's below average, but I did my job. After school and dance. Okay. Skills are also your social currency around here. Explain. We're going to want to cash in at the school, the social currency that you accrued over the course of the day. For instance, Your status with Othello will most likely raise if you have high athletics and you decide to cash in with him. Oh, I see. Ahem! I know all the likes and dislikes of everyone on campus. Gan indulges in intelligence and knowledge. Kate loves intelligence and personality. Macbeth is all about that athletic life. They also like intelligence. Miranda likes intelligence and knowledge. Okay, gotcha. So, literally the complete opposite of me. Gotcha. Noted. I'm gonna write that down just in case. But listen, I've played enough Ultimate games where I know where to get the good ending. I mean, I was the only person that managed to score with Zoe in Monster Prom, so yeah. Othello loves personality as much as he loves athletics. Puck is all about intelligence and personality. Pity she has neither. Ooh, damn. Ugh. Viola loves personality. There you have it, dorks. So, what do you think you're good at? Okay, so... intelligence and knowledge. So, I kind of don't want to lie. So, I would say personality, but I really want to date Miranda, so I guess I'll just say knowledge. Knowledge, plus one. A bookworm, eh? Depending on the subject. Yep, that's me! Well, see you in class, senior classmate. Math. Hey, Hiro, did you see the light show last night? Light show? Yeah, there was totally a meteor shower as we were walking back to campus. You didn't see it? I must have missed it, trying to get a bunch of drunks home and all. We weren't all drunk. Puck, it's okay. I don't do magic when I get drunk. I'm sure you're safe, too. She doesn't know what she's talking about. Also, looks like the stuff on the board is exactly what I learned in senior year of high school, because I took pre-calc, and pre-calc fucking sucks. Everyone take your seats. Take your seats, please. Why is he shirtless? All the other dragons wore shirts. Why is he shirtless? Welcome to your senior year math class. As this is your senior year and we need to properly prepare you for the wide world and it's dangerous, things will be a bit different this year. Yeah, for one thing, we'll be out of here soon. Caliban's science department has come up with a technology that is going to reshape how this school teaches. Caliban? Oh! Is that Cthulhu? Holy shit, we have a Cthulhu! Nice! Hell yeah! Hello, I have equipped every classroom with a 3D virtual reality sensory system as to simulate a number of situations that will seem real, but won't be. Caliban, English please. That's the best that I can explain it. Oh, I think it's best that you see for yourselves. Yes, that works best. So it's not the best way to explain it. Good luck, kids! As the teacher says that, they write an equation on the board. As they do, the floor slowly begins to separate, showing a pool with two thresher sharks below. What the hell? Can you solve the equation before you all die by shark attack? Oh my god! I mean, then again, this is better than actual calculus, so I can do this. Appeal, do math, rally class, fight sharks. Fighting sharks would not be a knowledge or intelligence thing, so... do math! You barely leap over a few of your fellow students and write down a hastily thought-out solution on the whiteboard. It turns out to be wrong, but the teacher likes your guts. Only one student falls into the shark pit. Oh no! It's already day one and we already have one death. F! Ayo, but I got one plus one intelligence, though. The teacher nods to you, then tells the class to simmer down. The instruction goes forward. This virtual reality thing is pretty neat. Theater! Oh, there's Kate and Puck. I'm so excited. The teacher is letting us decide what the senior play should be. We decide that you should pick. We're way too nervous. Shall it be a showcase of strength? Perhaps I may play Hercules and show everyone my raging muscles? Or will it be a romance and will I be kissing someone? Or like an Aaron Sorkin type with a lot of witty words? Hercules, surrealism, Aaron Sorkin, historical. Surrealism! Oh! Plus one knowledge! Nice! Music theory. Miranda! Hey, Yui, we're all picking on instruments. What's your favorite? Drums, electric guitar, metronome, violin. The only thing I know how to play is violin, because I played it in, like, second grade, even though I haven't played it since then, so I'm gonna say violin. Interesting. Takes a lot of patience to master, though. And I got plus one intelligence. History! Okay, due to budget cuts, I'm your senior year history teacher as well. Lucky me. Excuse me, but I do have an announcement. Of course, my king. There is to be a dance, a great homecoming dance. I decree that it shall be tonight. Prepare, young ones. That is all. Who do you think you'll take to the homecoming dance? I mean, this is nice and all, but don't you think it's a bit of a distraction? Oh, it's a distraction up to the wazoo. I'm still interested, though. Are you sure that you're no longer a cheerleader witch? Oh, come on. I'm just saying, that's more Viola's deal to get excited about these things. So for your first assignment, I have sealed this room and broken a vial of bubonic plit. Oh. Well, fuck. What? Yeah, I've read your history correctly. You will know how to cure it. Craft antibiotics, cyberplexin, rebuild civilization, fight plague. Craft antibiotics. Clear your tuning for me and craft some homemade medicine for the entire class. Plus one intelligence. Nice. Let's see how my stats are going. I have 2 knowledge, 3 intelligence. Nice. Phys Ed. What? Is that a fucking Halo reference? Did they really just slip in a Halo guy into this game? About furries and dating furries? Whatever. I'll take it at this point. Alright, ladies and gentlemen, listen up. You all put on a good show last night, but make no mistake. This year will push you to the limits. Some would even say to the max. You will give me nothing but 150%. It seems that this year shall tax us greatly. Our coach is not stopping for icebergs, if you catch my drift. I've been practicing all new cheers with my magic. It can be a one-woman cheer squad. Isn't this like the 5th time that you've been caught saying you're doing magic after saying you swore it off? Why, if it isn't the Loser Club. How is it going, losers? Athel might have won us the game last night, but what happens when his luck runs out? Insult skill, insult prejudice, insult knowledge, insult IQ. I'm gonna insult his IQ. You do realize that by saying that, you're expressing that you wanted us to lose a football game all because of your hatred for one individual. What are you on about? Dragons are rare in Elsinore. We have maybe 9 of them. Plus, your people historically haunted my people to near extinction. You're the real racist. Heh. Calling out a racist and I get plus 1 intelligence. That's how life goes, baby. Woo! Shop. Hello, class. I will be your teacher for engineering this senior year. After I brought back the dinosaurs in robot form 2 years ago, the staff was convinced that I need to be silenced and that they thus put me in charge of what I'm good at. Oh, this class is gonna be sick. Prepare to get an actual education in here. Mega sick! By the way, did anyone manage to catch the phenomenal meteor shower last night? Viola did, but you all know witches. Ah, well then, let us begin today's assignment. First, is Frankenstein the monster? No. He's the, Frankenstein is the doctor. What does that have to do with shop class? Whatever. Man, what a day. I think I can make senior year work. Hey heroes, so a few things. The homecoming dance is tonight, but right now you can talk to people in town as well as the quad before you venture off into the open world. Okay, got it. Hey hockey puck, why do you think that's clever? Face me, Faye, or do you think you're too good for human prime? What is it now, Tybalt? Oh, nothing. I just wanted to prove to you that you'll always do what humans say. Jerk isn't the right word for what that type of bullshit. If you want to talk, I'll be at Adronicus Park. Remember, Elsinore Academy is built on relationships and alliances. I'll make sure to check in on everyone before the event tonight. You can probably gain more social currency by going to dances with people, doing activities, things like that, so you can probably level up with someone a total of 3 times. 3 times? Once from all the skills you have gained over a school day, one from doing activities with them, and a third from nightly events. This is Elsinore. You never know what your real friends are and who is trying to stab you in the back. Arden has had a slew of bad kings and queens, and if you think this school is, well, I better get going. See you around. A few of us hang out at Jesus Crust, the pizza parlor, if you want. Oh, like Jesus Christ, that's cute, that's clever. Thanks, I'm sure I'll stop by. Here, I have a question. Have you noticed Viola acting a bit strange? Can you be more specific about that? She's literally a witch. No more than usual. It's just... she gets a major power upgrade, then Cleopatra, the head cheerleader, goes missing. I don't know, I'm just glad that I got out of the magic game when I did. Yeah, it seems like something that you're either into or not. That, and I don't want to be a weapon. Well, I'll see you later. Alright, I'll go to town. Let's see. Questions of interest. Dronicus Park Theater, Temporal Comics, Roller Derby, Cheese's Crust, Steamworks Library. Where would Miranda be? I'm gonna save here. Boop. Alright. I'm gonna assume she's gonna be at the theater? No, she's not. Kate's here though. Jesus Christ? Othello's here. Library? Ganymede's here. Steamworks? Macbeth. The park. Roller Derby? There's Miranda! Hey, Fran, what's going on? You here to watch? Watch what? Roller Derby practice. We go hard enough, we may have a shot at the championships this year. We got totally robbed last year. Oh, I didn't know that you were a part of the White Panthers. I try to keep in on the down low. My dad wouldn't approve. Doesn't Lord Prospero live on an island off the coast, though? Doesn't mean that he doesn't have eyes everywhere. In Arden, you need to assume that you're always being watched. True, but then wouldn't people already know? Not with magic. The form changes as well as anything that says Miranda King. Persona level up? I thought that you weren't doing the whole cheerleader witch thing anymore. Puck put up a few runes on my uniform. Yes, yes, I know that's still using magic, but I'm technically not cheating. Bay magic outside of the fairy realm is a big no-no to both communities. Is that a big risk? You won't tell, will you? Of course not. Relationship with Miranda has gained a level. Thanks, hero. You're the best. Good luck with practice. I'm gonna level up my skill. Relationship with Miranda has gained a level. Bye. I got 2 points on Miranda. Nice. Let's see who else I could hang out with. I'm gonna try hanging out with Puck. Here, I've been thinking. About what? Asking my dad for complete emancipation. I'd be human. Is that how that works here? Like, a real human? Mortal, yes. No fairy powers. Can your dad do that? Lord Oberon can do lots of things that affect reality, shape reality. That's why they signed the Treaty of Padua after the war ended. Arden wanted the Fae as military weapons, but not as civilians with powers. I remember reading about it, hence why some Fae now go to human schools. It was a trade-off. Some think we are spies for Oberon. The ones across the ocean, stripped of their powers during the Fae Wars. The ones placed in Rome, in other areas of the world. You might be spies, might not. Arden's always in some form of war, isn't it? I'll level up the skill. Relationship with Puck has gained a level. How do I go to the dance? Can I go to the dance now? Dance. I should really talk to everyone first. Oh, I gotta talk to everyone. So, I guess I'll talk to Othello. I say that pizza goes straight to your ass, but I say that any food is good because food is fuel. Skill level up. Othello is gaining a level. Okay. Fear. Kate. Ely, we're gonna put on the best play ever. The best since Prince Hamlet put on the murder of Gonzago? Yes. No, it will be better. It shall be the best, although I'm not really sure how I'm gonna stop staging a play to try to catch your dad's murderer. That's some hardcore shit right there. Skill level up. What ship with Kate? It's gained a level. Persona level up. Shame that acting group is now exiled and that the play is banned. So, in a sense, Hamlet's trap worked perfectly. I only wish to attain that level of meta-commentary with this senior play. I'm sure it'll be great. I'm sure scholars will debate it for generations and school children will grow sick of it being a staple of curriculum. Relationship with Kate is getting level. Gee willikers, I hope so. Bye. Ooh, I'm gonna go talk to Robin as well. Persona level up. Why would you want to be human? Everyone has daddy or mommy issues in Elsinore. Why should I be any different? That seems like a really lame excuse, to be honest, to give up your powers over reality. My dad can bend it to his will. I don't want any part of that. I have the opportunity to ask him to change me into something else, something that I actually am, and I feel more human than they. But why would he even allow that opportunity to exist? I can always ask. Do you support my decision? I guess of course I support what you want, but ultimately, it is yours to decide. Relationship with Puck, gain a level. Thank you, Yui. Bye. Okay. Temporal Comics. Talk to Viola. Isn't this the music from Pummel Party? It sounds like the Pummel Party music, does it not? Like the music that you hear before they start a game? Like, I'm not wrong, it sounds like the Pummel Party game music. Normally, I shit on people for reading comic books, but I'm trying to turn over a new leaf. No magic, no being a brat. I mean, I'd never give up cheerleading, though. Baby steps, Viola. Baby steps. I don't think that I've ever been into this store. It just seemed to appear out of thin air one day. Not literally, but if that literally happened, then I didn't see it. Old man Falstaff runs it now, but he's usually at the bar. Skill level up. You get the feeling that they are not impressed with your skills at the moment. Persona level up. So, Viola, you're the new head cheerleader, right? Ever since Cleopatra just up and vanished, yep. You don't think that's weird? Me being in a leadership position? No, Cleo just one day up and vanishing into thin air. I didn't do foul magic to her, if that is what you are asking. I'm not. Good, because I didn't. That's good to know. You believe me, right? Yes. Leadership Viola has gained a level. That means we won't have any problems. Yay! Okay. I'm gonna go back to talking to Othello. Persona level up. I too believe that all the food is fuel. Eat away, eat lord. I shall. Good talk, Othello. So I heard about you and Desdemona. Is there anything that I can do to help? No, but thank you. After coming here with my parents from Cyprus, I was so alone. Desdemona made me feel whole. I have no one but myself to blame. Don't beat yourself up. I wanted to see other people. She didn't. Shouldn't it be the other way around? I mean, an open relationship. Oh, so you're polyamorous, but she's not. Noted. Oh, well then, yeah. You can't force someone into something like that they don't want. She said she was cool with it. I guess that she really wasn't. Did I cheat on her? It feels that way. I mean, I guess you guys needed to communicate more with that. Like, yeah, she shouldn't have lied about, like, not being okay with it. Like, either that, or she just thought she would be okay with it, but then just wasn't really much into it. You did nothing wrong. You tried, but we can't force people to do what they don't want. You are wise. See ya, Othello. Alright, so far I got, my lowest one is Viola. Hopefully we can fix that soon. Steamworks. Macbeth. You wanna get drunk? Let's get drunk. Isn't the dance tonight? Do you care? Let's drink! Relationship with Macbeth has gained a level. I ever tell you about the time that Cleopatra and Viola tried to get me to kill Othello? Holy shit, you did not. Yeah, so that happened. Not my finest moment. Let's drink up. You don't need to tell me the story. No, not now, I don't know. But you should know who your drinking buddy is. And I gained a level with Macbeth. Alright, and finally the library with Gan. Hey, Ganymed, what's up? Oh, you know, the usual, looking up law type stuff. What for? As you know, my uncle and caretaker, Don Frederick, seized my dad's land during the War of the Roses, banishing him to the forest beyond Adronicus Park. Maybe in hopes that the Fae would kill him, I don't know. I'm trying to find a way to get the land back. Have you any leads? We're dealing with monarchs that allow their dukes and duchesses to do whatever the hell they want. It's the lawless Wild West. We're up against people that don't exactly follow the law. Don Frederick was able to use the War of the Roses to out his brother? How? Using war as a power grab isn't anything new. All you need to do is something as simple as declaring that my dad, Don Sr., was unfit to protect his territory. That's as easy as saying, hey, this guy or girl made one or two soft decisions. Do we know what he said? Yes. You know that he only took me in as a hostage, right? I mean, basically that's what I am. He does not care for me at all. He views me as weak. Jesus Christ, Gon! Are you good? Persona level up. So are you implying that Duke Frederick contested your father's right to lead by using you as an example? I'm not implying that, I'm saying that. There's gotta be a law in here stating that a duke cannot be ousted simply because their heir is deemed unfit for duties. I hope you find something. Thank you, Yui. Skill level up, and I gain a new level. Bye. Alright, I got two levels for everybody except for Viola, but we can work with this. Well, here it is, first dance of the year. These are just rumors, poppycock stories. Hehe. He said cock. But is my job safe? No one is buying to school. It has been ruled by my family for generations. Who do I dance with? Miranda. Relationship with Miranda's gained a level. You choose your dance partner, and as the band plays, you dance. The band then starts a slow dance, and you and your partner awkwardly sway to the music. There's another meteor shower. It's closer, and it's gigantic! Suddenly, everyone stops what they are doing and rushes outside. It's like one of those parodies where everyone is all super hyped to see this very esoteric thing. Where are they? I can't see them. Just wait. Oh! Oh, wow. That is quite a sight. They're beautiful. They're so close. Meteors is close. It's common, but this is weird. Yeah, look at them. They don't look like meteors to me. They look like scratches. Little white eraser marks. Now that she mentioned it, they did like places in the sky where there was just nothing. But they moved so quickly that it was anyone's guess as to if it was something more than a meteor shower. What if it's the Fae attacking? God, it is not the Fae attacking! We all stare at the shower for a long time. Then we seem to remember the dance and we suddenly all return to the gym. But boy, what a homecoming. Hey, Yui, out for morning job? Yep, the air is crisp and fresh. Yeah, I forgot when it was last like this. I remember it taking at least a full year for the stench of the war to dissipate. Hey, Miranda, are you practicing for the big game? Not so loud. The spell that I gave you to conceal your identity is pretty nifty, though it won't glitch out. It better not, my dad might have my head, literally. Doesn't Lord Prospero have, and I quote, 1,000 young? So why don't one of your brothers or sisters just come here and start doing the whole royalty and training thing instead? I don't want to transfer Dad's pressure onto them. Besides, Dad seems to want me to be the one to take up the mantle. Hey, you guys hear about this assembly that we're supposed to be having this morning? No, I didn't get a notification, email, or anything. Yeah, it's supposedly now. Act 2. More things. What is the meaning of this? Sire? So which one of you called this assembly? I didn't. Me neither. I don't have the authority. Well, the students are filing in. We need to say something. Hello. Thank you for coming with such haste to today's assembly. Thank you, Claudius. That will be all. Hello? Who dares? Oh, it feels so cool to be able to finally do the reveal. Oh, hello! Please tell me I get to date her, right? Because I like her. She's really quirky, and she has that cute little hoodie. Guards! You may call me Senpai, for I have noticed you.
Holy shit, Senpai noticed us.
But seriously, I found you guys in a nexus of dating sim dimension, the Shakespeare ones to be exact. Oh, is she from another game? Who is she? I'll have to look her up later. Shall I dispose of this scoundrel? Oh, that's okay, I brought my own. I would dare not mess, but if you do insist, we can indeed get our sexy on Sexy Hamlet. His name's Sexy Hamlet. Oh my. Relax. This dear boy is Sexy Hamlet, and as such, he has some properties. Hamlet. Oh, not your Hamlet. I found this macho man in another Shakespeare dating sim dimension. Now call off your dog. Sire. It is okay, Johnny. Johnny? Is that Falstaff? What? We have a teacher named Falstaff. They are a dragon. Oh, that is very interesting. I like that. I am Johnny Dark Terror's cur. This is a Shakespeare world. Your name is not Johnny Dark Terror's. Sire, what do I do? Stand down. That's right. Now watch this. What the fuck? What the fuck is this? Why is he stick figure? What's going on in this game? Oh, I'm guessing like this person is like the creator of these games or something like that. I have no idea. I'm so confused. What are you doing? What have you done? Viola. I have no idea how that was done. Also, I'm too busy staring at the other one's chest.
Titties.
Wow, that is so hot that it makes a dragon want to retire, man. What did you do to me? Oh, be thankful that I didn't just erase you. I just stick figured you. We're still figuring out the scientific terminology. That stuff takes time. Oh, relax. Eventually you'll reform into whatever I want you to be. You shall pay for this. Be thankful that I didn't just stick figure your entire goddamn world due to your insolence. I believe that it is time for introductions, sir. Hello, children. My name is Keegan Quinn. I'm a dimension hopper along with my friend Sexy Hamlet right here. I'm your new headmaster. My talents include writing The Source of Reality, a highly profitable franchise that ripped off a lot of other material from lots of other more famous authors of other dimensions. There's a bit of wizards, a bit of wardrobe, some red ferns growing in some chapters. It was a witchcraft and wizardly series that was like, ooh, cool, I'm the chosen wizard. It was contracted by some actual mages that I guess were sick of misinformation. Did that one in a Lovecraft dimension. I then started up a video game company in another. Now I decided to invade your school and give the principal thing a try. Ready to initiate scans? Right. As your names are called, would the following students please come forward? Othello Moore. I have you know, villain, that you shall not succeed. Oh, Fex isn't a villain. She's an artificial intelligence. She's not even human. Oh, you meant me. I get it now. Next, Miranda King. Oh, I like you. Yes, indeed. You'll be a fantastic foil to the geek archetype for the player. Oh? What are you talking about? Oh, I can't give away spoilers. Viola Anschultz. Holy mackerel, real life cat girl. Boy and girls, we hit the jackpot coming to this world. I know, an actual cat girl. But I'm not interested in her. I'm interested in Miranda. Robin Puck. The Fae. Oh, you and I are going to be great friends. Also, Phil's the literal magic quota and manic pixie girl. That's a ridiculous stereotype. Macbeth Dale. Ah, the wild card. It'll be interesting to see how many people pick you. I'm going to repeat Othello's words. Yeah, sure. Ganymede Urquhart. You'll find that Elsinore doesn't take kindly to strangers. Kate Nantucket. Look, I'm just going to come out and say it. Y'all say that you are from a different dimension, universe, whatever. Why do you all look so one-dimensional? Ah, that is a very good question. Yes, it is because we come from a very different universe. You see, we have yet to acclimate to this world's reality. That's kind of super rad, but I still don't like any of you. Fair enough. Fex, is that all? Those are all the potential candidates, yes. So, should we burn the skull? I feel like just having it pop out of existence would be way less dramatic. Sir, you are forgetting yourself in your lust to get to the end game. There are still things to be done here. Oh, you are quite right, Sexy Hamlet. Assembly dismissed, and I do mean that. You have first periods, do you not? Everyone shuffled out, watched closely by Fex, the strange AI. Or is it just Fex? You don't think you'll get a chance to ask. Caliban, please stay. Yes? There are things that we must discuss. I have plans for you. I guess we go into math. I know that these squiggly lines seem weird, but I do promise that they mean something. I don't even know why I'm saying this. You are in a university math class. Yeah, where we're all subjected to things like shark pits opening up from under us if we get a question wrong. These things happen. Now let's begin. Excuse me for one moment. I think that the children should be allowed to learn things they want, grow in their own way regardless of anything else. I will now make it all so students shall be able to see the results of their actions and pick according to what they desire. But how's that learning? How's your face learning? Oh, burn! Wait, what? You heard me. This is my classroom. I am sorry, but I am Mr. Quinn's personal robot, so I can do whatever I want. I choose to sit in. Oh, Quinn's an actual dude. Oh, Quinn's a dude. Like, I thought they were, like, calling them sir, because, you know, like, yes, sir, but I didn't realize they were an actual dude. My bad. Fine, today's lesson was going to involve, I disabled one of your satellites. What are you talking about? It is currently hurtling towards the classroom. You have but a few scant minutes to solve how to save yourself with math. Knowledge, athletics, intelligence, personality. I do need to get personality up, so... And I'll just use intelligence. But Fex, we don't have any satellites currently passing by this region. You're lying. Hell yeah. This virtual reality tech is indeed as fascinating as I originally thought. Mr. Quinn shall be pleased. The teacher nods meekly to you, then tells the class to simmer down. Okay. Theater. Oh man, I'm so excited to start casting our play. Same, I know that it'll be great. Why, hello, children. What? I am to be your new theater instructor. Consider me your friend, ally, and shoulder to cry on. We make art in the classroom, children. Oh, he's so dreamy. I shall follow your lead anywhere, as I have found my equal in sexiness. Nay, my superior. Okay, have you all gone mad? My scans indicate that your field of sex appeal does not affect this one. For starters, I'm not attracted to dumbasses. Secondly, we had a play all planned out. But I am your teacher. I can override your decision. Yeah, Kate, stop being a bitch. I'm gonna let that slide because I think there's something not quite right about what this guy is doing to your brains. I am to be your stage manager. What shall our play be, oh great one? The Tale of Hamlet, of course. I should have guessed. Who shall play the demanding psychological role of Hamlet? Sexy Hamlet. Ah, knowledge. I clearly know the role. Is this your choice? Remember that your choice of actor will sway your audience's emotions in one way or another. Yes. Nice. Teacher nods to you, then tells the class to simmer down. Music theory. I like music. I know I am but a machine, but I enjoy the sound of music, not the sound of silence. Good to know. For your instructions today, what is the best genre of music ever? Folk, hard rock, light rock, the 1980s. Light rock? Ah, personality. Is this really the best music ever? Yes. Nice. Teacher nods to you, then tells the okay. I don't know why I keep reading that, even though it's the same thing on the last one. History. Today's history assignment. You're Alexander Hamilton, and you are fighting Aaron Burr. What do you do? Personality. I talk my way out. I reason with Burr. Phys Ed. Alright, ladies and gentlemen, listen up. I do not agree with the FEC system's new rule that we show you the outcome of your actions before you take them. But let's treat this like just another obstacle. Let's crush it. I believe in us, coach. I believe in the team. That's right. But do you believe in your team enough to have your back when you need to do dental reconstructive surgery on an alligator? Seems oddly specific, but okay. I would sing the gator its favorite lullaby, putting it into a deep sleep so we can work safely. The teacher nods to you. Shot. Dad will never find out. Miranda, do you know how naive you sound? Cal, he is not your dad. This is between me and him. I'm not your brother, no, but we both came from the Arkham Island, and we both know what he's like. Again, I'm his kid, you're not. I'll need a refresher on how cruel a ruler Lord Prospero is. I just want you to be safe. You're my friend. Cal, I appreciate it, but you've got to let me handle my own shit. Okay, listen up. The new management has a few wacky ideas that they say they want set in stone. I'm not really jiving with them, but can't believe I'm saying this, but I miss Claudius. On to today's lesson, which is... I miss my old robots, the ones I'd make in my garage. What type of robot would you make me to cheer me up? Tyrannosaurus Rex robot to go with your big personality. Man, what a day. Puck, we need to talk. Is Quinifei? I don't think so. My dad, he can't do what he was done to Claudius. He can't alter reality. At least, like that. Also, there's the truce. You're thinking this was an invasion. Dad would not harm the Treaty of Apatia. We need to find out what Quin is, who they are. They said that their tones were still... acclimating to this dimension. Right, we can start there. Puck, can you try talking to your dad? I know that you don't like to. I can, Gan. I will try. Thank you. This year just got more interesting. Oh, for sure. Tonight is date night around Elsinore Village. Tonight, you'll probably be able to get a double status points with people if you so choose to go out with them. I'll keep that in mind. So date night, you got anybody that you're going with anywhere? I tend to be a lone wolf. Things are quieter that way. Mac, Viola, how are you? I'm fine. That's good. She seems skittish around you. Oh, did they used to date? My past doesn't look fondly on witches. Many were used for the war. Cleopatra also did a number on her when she was still around. Speaking of around, see you. Freaking damn it! What's going on? My dad, he wants to see both of us. Lord Oberon? What does the Fae King want with me? I don't know, but we best not keep his douche-ness waiting. That would be bad. Does everyone in the school have a shitty family? Pretty much, yeah. More or less. Royalty, you know. That's a lot of pressure. Here we are. Ooh, pretty. It looks like that one town in Pokemon, in the Hoenn region. I forgot what it was called, but I know Winona was the gym leader.
Indeed, child. What is it that you want, Lord Oberon?
Isn't that just Robin's thing, but flipped and with a black thing over it?
I want for nothing. I need knowledge.
What is the knowledge that you seek? This new person, the one who did that miraculous thing to King Claudius, what do you know of him?
Quinn and his minions came in and took over.
I care not for their minions. They interest me, but ultimately bore me.
This one calling itself Quinn is the one that catches my eye the most. He has power.
What do you want from us, Dad?
I did not sense Quinn before they popped into existence.
I want you, Puck, dear daughter, to learn and report. You, Hero, shall also learn and report.
Why Hero?
Quinn feels like Hero.
Oh, okay. Well, fair enough, I guess. And also, I'm sorry, I keep calling myself Hero. I keep forgetting that, yeah.
What? What does that mean?
I do not know. There is not a lot that I do not know. Humanity, for instance, is something that I wish to learn about, and yet this Quinn is a different kind of knowledge gap.
Quinn feels like me. Explain.
I just told you I do not know.
You want to know how Quinn hops universes,
among other things.
Quinn's power exceeds mine in ways that I just cannot understand.
We get it, Quinn's something new.
Go now, go to your date night.
Oh, and Puck, amazing job with Miranda, truly wonderful. I do wish to see it play out.
Let's get out of here.
I feel like Quinn? How does that mean?
My dad always has motives. He's not telling us everything, or a flip side. He is telling us everything. That only makes me more worried.
Why do you look like you, a shadow version of you?
That's what I want to know.
Oh, that's his way of fucking with people. He likes to shine a mirror or such on their soul. He's weird.
Alright, let's go to town. Let's see if we can try and find Miranda.
Park.
Puck.
Oh, I could ask her up, but I don't want to, so I'm gonna level up her skill.
I wanna ask out Miranda, so I'm guessing I'm gonna go to the roller derby.
Miranda!
Level up!
Ask her out!
Miranda, would you like to go out?
On a date?
Sure, just let me finish practice. We've got a bit left.
Cool, I'll see you later then.
I need pizza.
Sounds good!
Oh, look at her outfit! She's the big titty furry GF! She's the big, fluffy, furry goth GF. Let's go!
Once again, I am not a furry.
So, what do you think you're going to do after school?
Prospero probably is going to call me back to the island.
What do you want to do, though?
I got into witchcraft because I thought that's what I wanted to do. In reality, it was merely a distraction.
The question is open.
Well, what do you like?
I like roller derby, but I'm not sure it's a distraction yet. I keep going back and forth.
Well, regardless of what you find out about yourself, we're all here for you.
Relationship with Miranda's gained a level.
Thank you. For now, I'd like to eat food.
We eat and we talk.
So, the big roller derby game is tonight.
I know, I'm so excited for Miranda.
Act 3.
Oh, I didn't get to read that. Shit, can I go back?
I guess I don't get to read that. Oh well.
But are you sure this is the right world? That it has what we need?
Oh crap, here comes Quinn and that sexy Hamlet dude.
He's so creepy, everyone loves him for some reason.
Probably because he's, sexy?
You and Puck both hide behind cover and listen in.
Their narration keeps jumping tenses. How is this a perfect being?
We are very close to gaining the power to create the ultimate dating sim. The young men and women that Fex has picked out will be fine additions to the current lineup.
So we're destroying this world.
I'm not sure yet.
How do you know that this is the right world?
You saw the scores, you saw their answers. This is the right world. We have found who we are looking for.
What we are looking for.
What are the world's Oberon?
Much like our quarry, the world's Oberon has the right DNA.
This was so fucking lucky, sexy Hamlet. We could have gone straight by this one. We almost did, but it was our Goldilocks planet.
Do we tell the others?
Not yet. We don't want to get them riled up. We don't know enough yet.
Alright, I guess we're just gonna continue on with class. Gotcha.
Hello, children. Today we're going to change things up a bit. I'm going to ask you questions about dating.
Oh boy, here we go.
Why, this is math. What do you look for in a geeky archetype? Intelligence, knowledge, personality. Yeah. Personality. Awesome, let's continue with these simulations. But this is math class. Let's answer more dating-related math questions. This goes on for a while. You're so happy when the bell rings and the period ends. Theater. Today we shall pick Ophelia. I really have to question this method of picking a new cast member per day. I could say Miranda, but what if she falls for sexy Hamlet? So I'm gonna say Viola. Ah, personality. She will win over the aunts with her childlike charm and decency. Is this your choice? Remember that the actor will sway your audience's emotions in one way or another. Yes. Teacher nods. Music theory. Hello, kids. Say you're in a romantic comedy. What music would you want as your soundtrack? Folk, country, death metal, classical jazz. Classical jazz. Okay. History. Hello, class. Today, I have a very simple question for you. If you were to, say, find yourself at a school full of dateable historical persons, who would you want most on that roster? Confucius, Babe Ruth, Marie Curie, Julius Caesar. Julius Caesar. Phys Ed. Team, today, Headmaster Quinn has a question regarding fitness. My question is simple. What is the most important trait of attraction to keep in mind when exercising? Athleticism? Alright, shop class. So today we're going to be doing things a bit differently. We have these VR headsets that I've designed and Quinn wants repurposed for, well, he wants you to put them on and you'll figure out the rest. Let's hope this works and doesn't kill us all. Wait, what? What the hell is this, Cal? What the hell? Are we at the Grand Canyon? View is nice, huh? I'm going to swear off magic. This is my last thing. What? Why is Viola a human? Didn't you tell me that you struck a deal with the ghost to get rid of Cleopatra? And now Kate's human? This is my last thing, Kate. Okay, okay. Jesus, Kate, this better work. Now Caliban is human? Sort of. He has green skin, but what? I know. What? Hello? Who's there? I know what you should be seeing is another dimension. That is, I mean, I did it right, so it's probably working. Who summoned Lord Oberon? You can summon a fake king without words? I think it's in my head. How freaking powerful are you? Oh, she's pretty powerful. She banished her athletic superior to a fey realm. Oh, that's what happened to Cleopatra. Okay, yeah, I figured Viola did something. Also, I guess she's just wearing a beaver onesie, I guess. So I guess Viola just is a little whippersnapper in every dimension. A murderous little whippersnapper. Oh, great Lord Oberon. Where is my daughter? Where is Robin Puck? I do not sense her. I do not sense her on this planet. Max actually really wanted to ask you. All our friends are gone. Vanished. We need your power. Boy, I just said that Puck is gone. If she were on Earth, I would be able to sense her. She is gone. Crap! Cal, what is this? 1 second. Hold on. Caliban? Almost got it. There we go. Nobody is here to protect you now, freaks. Oh, hello, human Tybalt! Shee! Why don't you go off somewhere and fondle yourself, Tybalt? Ooh, burn! Okay, so Kate is still fantastic. Tybalt's still a dick. I know that you went to Don Sr.'s camp. I know you summoned Lord Oberon. Wait until the king hears about this. Using forbidden human magic is one thing, but humans are not allowed to wield fey magic. Don't you have a bowl of dicks be eating? No? No, he does. He's pretty gay. He's just in denial. So unrefined, Catherine. Tybalt Capulet. These children are none of your concern. But King Hamlet, the witch wields forbidden magic. It is not your concern, Tybalt. Leave us. Viola, a word? Yes, King Hamlet? Your magical abilities grow. Do you think that I do not know? As long as you keep me in communication with my dead father, the one slain by fool Claudius, who I in turn killed in combat, you are saved. But do not contact Oberon again. That guy creeps me out. Which one? Both. Caliban, why am I seeing this dimension? Caliban? Hello? I just don't know where they went. Miranda, Othello, Puck, Ganymede, and the rest. Wait, those are the exact same students that Quinn singled out. Is this connected? Perhaps I should try to communicate with one of these kids. One of us? Kate. I can use Kate's personality to win people to my cause. What is my cause? Yes. You start typing or trying to type on one of the computers that Kate is working on. Suddenly your words appear on her screen. What the? You frantically write a Bible-link rundown of everything that has happened this far. This is super weird. Okay, time's up. Well, I hope they got the message. I hope they don't think that they are just gone insane. What are they talking about? Didn't you see the other you? No, the headsets didn't work. What did you see? Oh, I saw nothing, I guess. Yeah, I just straight up went insane. Uh-huh. Well, let's continue today's lesson in electronics, shall we? What a day. To the quad! Everyone is coming to the derby tonight to cheer you on, Miranda. Even though, you know, nobody will know it is you. Thanks, Puck. Let's go to town. Let's hang out with Miranda! Miranda! Persona level up. Hey, Miranda. Did you hear? Hear what? Elsinore may be formally annexing Arkham. Wait, what? Annexation means absorbing a territory on the same landmass. Not entirely. War? You know Prospero better than I do. But Elsinore and Arkham, hell, Arkham and the rest of the world have a good relationship. People marry their sons and daughters to the Arkham houses in order to get their power into the future bloodlines. What possible reason would there be for war? I'm sure it's nothing, Miranda. I'm sure that it's just nothing nations having squabbles. Relations with Miranda's gained a level. Let's hope so. Yes, indeed. So, that's not the best news ever. Skill level up? Nice. Bye. Alright, so my skills with Miranda are pretty good. 8 skills, look at that. I don't have a 1 in athletics, but my intelligence personality is going well, and I have a 4 in knowledge. Alright, let's try and see if we can hang out with Viola again. Viola! Persona level up. Am I a bad person? I know that people think I'm ignorant to the world, but am I a bad person? What? No, I don't think so. Because I totes killed the last head shield with magic. Yeah, we all know that. It's very obvious. You killed Cleopatra? Well, I mean, I didn't know she's dead. All I know is that I traded her to the Lord Oberon for power. You do know that dealing with the Fae King is punishable by years and years in prison, right? I'm not even going to bother going into you traded a human. I know, I'm awful. You're not awful. You kind of are, but whatever. Yay! You're not awful, but you did do something horrible. But I'm living with it. I'm dealing with it. That's why you're not absolutely horrible. And I gained a relationship. Alright, finally I can get Viola's thing leveled up. Let's hang out with Puck. Persona level up. Dad wants to see me up at the tree houses. We are not to discuss this further. I know that you can turn people mortal. Daughter, this is not happening. I hate this! Why even have you try to be human if we can actually be human? We are Fae. We are forever. This is final. I know what you're trying to do. Have you been spying on me? No. Kind of. If Oberon is up to something, I'd like to know. Oberon is not your business, Cal. I know, but coming from where I come from, King Claudius and King Prospero are a very different type of shitty parent from a Fae parent. Robin, I get it, I do. Look at me. You think that Prospero sent me here to learn how to run a country? You're fine, Cal. Buzz, wrong. I was sent here because I have no place in Prospero's kingdom. I'm too smart. I know I'm too smart, and I'm an invalid. He has no use for someone who literally won't toe the line. Don't talk like that. I don't give a shit about my chair. It's who I am. But I'm an invalid on Arkham, and I'm an invalid here. I also look like this. Yeah, you literally look like Cthulhu, my dude. You think it's a coincidence that Prospero has so many children, and yet Miranda was sent here to learn life skills? I think you're fine that the way you are, Puck. Me too. Friendship with Puck is gaining a level. Thanks, guys. I just wish that I felt the same.
Aw, Puck. Yes, you're the manic pixie dream girl, but you are a baby. Not as much as a baby as Miranda, but still, I love you. Alright, let's go hang out with Kate. How's it going, Kate? I'm slowly working through my reading list of every single play in existence. That sounds hard. You don't make a hit show on Broadway if you're ignorant. I'm gonna take New York by storm. Want to help me make a storm-generating machine? That would make this easier. Keep being awesome, Kate. I mean, sure. Skill level up. See ya, Kate. Alright, let's go hang out with Othello. Othello, I wanted to ask you, if it's not too personal, do you still have romantic feelings for Desdemona, as in, do you want her back? Of course I do. Then what's stopping you? This is our senior year. We'll all be off to parts unknown soon. It is not that simple. I know that you have it in you to at least try. I appreciate that, but when I first wooed Desdemona, it was as a war hero, fresh from the fight. I regaled her with tales of bravery, tales of violence, tales of things that she never experienced. But in turn, things changed. She changed me. How so? I no longer needed that rush anymore. Oh, I still am a fighter, but it no longer drives me. You should talk to her, at least. I don't think you'd want to lose the friendship. No, anything but that. And I gained a new skill. Let's go to Steamworks. Hey, Macbeth. Have you thought about therapy? I appreciate you looking out for me, hero, but I'm not a hurt bird. If the Cheerleaders are homicidal, then we should let someone know. Cleopatra was the ringleader. I don't think Viola has it in her. You are not afraid of being tempted again? I know that I have that in my heart. It's something that I've just got to deal with on my own. It doesn't need to be on your own. Your concern is noted. Is it? Yes, actually. You get the feeling that they are not okay. Yeah, I can't do a skill level up with Macbeth, but I'm not really trying to woo Macbeth anyway, so I don't care. Alright, finally, let's go to Gan. Hey, Gan. So how's the search going? So now that Duke Frederick is on the school board, he has that powerful cable of bullshit backing him. But, and hear me out here, Quinn is in Caladius. He'll have different ideas. I don't think Quinn really cares about this world. He's up to something. We just need to figure out what. I can't let that distract me, though. I have my mission. I'll help in whatever way I can. Thank you, but I think you and the others should focus on Quinn. Figure that out. It's not safe to go alone. It's safer to do that. You already expect me to be the hostile to them. That's why it shouldn't be you. That's why it has to be. Their prejudice will override their guard, if that makes sense. Duke Sr. is my father. I need to do this. Okay, I won't stop you. Come on, I want to show you something. So this is Duke Sr.'s camp. It's literally just the tree houses where Puck is from. Duke Frederick essentially permits him to live in the forest, but of course I'm the hostage. The Fae have claimed this place now. You know that you have a place with us, right, Gan? Thank you. You are the only things beside my sanity that I truly have. Duke Freddy is a bad guy. Bad guys always slip up. I hope that you are correct. Honestly, I wasn't, like, too keen on, like, the dragon dudes, but I really like Gan. Gan's pretty cool. Like, I don't know. He's probably, like, the only dragon I might date. The other ones aren't really that attractive, but I like Gan's personality. And I gained a level with him. Alright, let's check out my skills. My relationship with Miranda's pretty high. Close second, we have Puck. And tied for third, we have Othello, Gan, and Kate. With Viola and Macbeth at the bottom. Let's go to the derby. We all took our seats. Miranda came out to say hi. Good luck. Break some legs. I'm just gonna pretend the other team is every guy that has ever been shitty to me. Something that actually were. Added plus. Hell yeah, Miranda. I like that spirit. We all cheered and hollered as the skaters took their places and then started, well, skating and beating each other up. At intermission, Viola led the Elsinore White Panthers roller cheer squad. I had no idea that Viola pulled double duty. She is a cheer machine. I would say so. The White Panthers came out for the second round and won the night. Everyone erupted in applause like a frickin' volcano. That was a good game. We're all going out for ice cream later. You coming? Yeah, sure. That was so cool, Miranda. Thank you, hero. That was indeed quite a show, m'lady. Oh, God. Never mind. I'm not attracted to Tybalt anymore. He's an r/nice guy. Never mind. I normally don't approve of women. Of course you don't. You didn't let me finish.
I normally do not approve of women participating in violence. I find it base. But you are most fetching tonight. DeBolt, would you approve of, say, Miranda King doing something like this? Oh, please, she is a fine lady. Plus, it might hurt her breeding. No offense, my lady, as I'm sure you are very fine as well. I fucking hate this. I hate this. Bruh, I can't believe I thought that DeBolt was cute. Ew. He's a Reddit user. Oh, every offense is taken. Well, it shouldn't be. But it was. Did you see that? Didn't even know who I was. I gain confidence every time I see proof of the spell working. Oh yeah, right, because she disguised herself. Man, I wish that they had more, I don't know, like, character art to, like, you know, show expressions and shit like that. Because I keep forgetting that she disguises herself. So who am I going to ask out for private ice cream tasting away from the others? Miranda. They say sure. Yes! Miranda, you were wonderful. Verona didn't stand a chance. Thanks. Those Verona Academy scallywags never saw it coming. Now we are 2 for 2. Hopefully that keeps up. No good run lasts forever. We just need to prep for when we fail. Slander, that'll never happen. Yes, I'm out for ice cream and you both go and have a good time. Eventually you are joined by all of your friends, but only after some intimate conversation. No, not that type of intimate. Get your head out of the gutter. No, I wasn't thinking that because I'm not a furry. Well, it seems it is time to head back for the night. Hero, wish to speak with you. Okay. I have summoned you all here for different reasons. First, I will applaud Miranda and Puck for their deception. Very clever. Oh. Second, what have you learned of Quinn? Daddy wants you for something. Most fascinating. That sounds super bad. Yeah, that sounds really suspect. Now I would speak to Miranda and Viola, the one who once tempted and the one tempted still. Miranda, do you miss your witchcraft? Has this experience not pulled on your heart? You and I both know that Lord Prospero, your father, he would not take kindly to his chosen child partaking in sports. I know Prospero well. He dabbles in magic, much like most royals, but unlike most, he is particularly fancy to it. Would he not be pleased at your deception? No offense, Fey King, but you do not know him like I do. Fair enough. Fair enough. Viola, you'd make a very powerful soldier in my ranks. I'm good here. I know your internal struggle, that cold that could end. I fight with my pom-poms. You are a sweet summer child. Go now. I will take all of your dialogue into consideration. After that super weird encounter, we all said goodnight and went our separate ways. Okay. You get up quite refreshed. A new day means new plans. Act 4. Who's Claudius? Well, good hero. Off to class. Bright and early, I see. Off to class at the same time as always. I ended up talking to Desdemona. And how'd it go? We are too different. She thought about it, but in the end... I'm sorry, man. A new day, a new dawn. We all have to work things in our own heads, right? Right. You'll be fine in time. Yes. Well, we best get to class. Aw, poor Othello. At least he talked to her. I'm proud of her for that. Aliens arrive on the planet. How would you describe math to them? We're just getting straight into it. Okay. I would introduce them to the theories of our great leaders in the field and those that are lost to us. Theater. In this class, we make theater. We make love.
What do you mean by that?
Sure. You know what I mean. Do we though? Yes, you do. Do you know what you mean? Now we will decide upon who shall play Claudius. I swear to this fucking guy. Kate, speak up, please. I did not hear you. I said you're weird. As an olive branch, I shall let you direct the play. You will learn valued skills. Okay, that saves me a bunch of time on plotting your downfall. Jesus, Kate! Damn, I should have gone for her instead of Miranda. I take it you accept. Sure thing. We do it in our street clothes. No fancy dress. Kate, that's good. We are artists, using what we have, showing ourselves as we are, connecting on a personal level with the play. Plus, it saves money. Now, Claudius. I'd say... Claudius himself. Ah, personality. Keegan will be more than happy to have Claudius relive his bullshit trauma on stage. Is this your choice?
Remember that your choice of actor will save your... Okay, yeah. Yes. Music theory. If I were a savage beast... Wait, no. Let me start again. I realize that I don't want to use a personalization for this question. If you were enslaved in a castle of a savage beast, what music would you use to soothe their heart and possibly have sex later on with? Wait, what? Why is this a topic? What does this have to do with what we're currently studying? I'm confused. Is it sex later or sex later on? Viola, just keep looking at your pom-poms. They're so cute. Just do your cheer routine, Viola. Oh, my apologies. It was the placement of whip, wasn't it? Also, this is an incredibly inappropriate question. This is an incredibly inappropriate topic for... We're in a music class. So just to be clear, we're trying to seduce the savage beast with music, not are you going to have sex with them? Sex is for sure, right? Oh my god, Viola, please! That is what I meant. Yes, words are hard sometimes. Knowledge. I recall the musical selections that I played during my captivity. I would also tailor that decision into whatever interactions that the beast and I have had so far. History! This will be a free read period. Okay, gang, we've got to figure out who or even what Keegan Quinn is. I vote for what? I don't think that he is a fae. Not even Oberon has the powers that Quinn has shown. Plus his implication that he could destroy the world. Or at least paperfy it, like he did with Claudius. I mean, one of those old books has to have something, right? If not on Quinn themselves, then there's gotta be info on this other universe he talked about, Lovecraft. He called this a Shakespeare dimension, whatever that is. So yes, I'd look up anything to do with time travel, parallel dimensions, and the cosmos, anything like that. Okay, so now they call Quinn them. So I'm guessing Quinn is non-binary, but femme-presenting and just use he-they pronouns. I don't know, Quinn's an enigma, but I respect them. Maybe Lovecraft exists in this world the same way Shakespeare doesn't, whatever those two things are. He thumbed through the library and eventually asked Mr. Falstaff for his advice on reading material. Finally respecting your old teacher enough to ask their opinion, what book are you looking for? What's your poison? Something involving quantum physics or something. You want to learn more about your situation. Phys Ed! Sports ain't all about muscle, it's also about your brain. Mr. Dark Terrors, the brain is also a muscle. Yeah, which you don't use any of. I can turn you into a newt. She could, Tybalt. Then my daddy would sue you. How much wood would a woodchuck chuck if a woodchuck could chuck wood? Convince the woodchuck to work for you. You'll make it rich into wood carving business. Not for sure. This entire Keegan Quinn debacle is a Lovecraftian plot, isn't it? Wait, Lovecraft? What's Lovecraft? That's one of the dimensions that Quinn said he found. What do you know? I mean, he's literally Cthulhu, so of course he would know about Lovecraft. Oh, Lovecraft is a nobody. He's Professor Jero. On Arkham Island? Why would a jester be important? I imagine that he's quite different in other dimensions. Okay, thanks. Yeah, anytime. You're up to bat, Yui. Are you sure that this is safe, talking to other universes? We need all the intel on the enemy that we can get. What if Quinn has yet to be to the world that Yui is trying to talk to? Leave it to Caliban to create a device that can communicate with other realities. Yes, but let's keep it down. We do not want others to hear, especially that Vex thing. Ready to go back in? Ready as I'll ever be to attempt something like this. Here goes nothing. Inhales deeply, exhales. Hal, I'm worried. These power outages, do you think they are related to the Fae? I would not bother with such thoughts, Cressida. What honestly does bother me, though, is that these power outages seem to happen every time one of our students claims to have contacted someone else. You're talking about through the computers. Technomancy? So you heard this too. Oh yeah, because we tried to talk to the human Kate. Fae, rumors of King Hamlet the First ghost dropping by, and now this. It's too much, Hal. I may quit. Go back to Rome. Go back home. We'll figure it out, Cressida. We'll always do. We are Elsinore. We are strong. Yo! I'm here! Sup, you there? They slowly sit down at the computer and boot it up.
Okay, so I need to make a connection here. What do I write about? Knowledge. Write about your Elsinor, what it's like, the hopes and dreams of its people. Okay, I'm ready. What'd you see? What'd you say to them? I'm gaining their trust. Do we even have a plan? Warn them about Quinn? So no. Hero, we could all be destroyed at any minute. Which is why we need a plan other than just going in there and hoping for a miracle. I doubt they know how to defeat Quinn. We're running out of time. I know that. Seer's gonna end up killing me. Tonight is date night around Elsinore Village. Tonight you'll probably be able to get double status points if people list to choose to go out with them. I'll keep that in mind. I cannot enter school grounds. If I do, the human fate truce is broken. Did you not know this, mortal? How do you know that I'm mortal? I do not, but I sense that you can be killed. I can kind of be killed, yes. Shit, let's hide. Fine, I'll walk the 5 feet it takes to get to you. You and Puck hide behind cover. You are the intruder, the one not from this place. You're Lord Oberon, king of the Fae folk. Fairies are awesome, don't you think? Yes. You have no idea how long you've been searching for an Oberon with your qualities. Thank you? Not like I like to call a chosen one. Out of all the Oberons, you are the most Oberon. You confuse me, traveler. What is it that you want? I mean, really want. I have sussed out what you are doing and understood it to the limitations of my mind. You collect things from places. Why? That's not really important right now. You may not know what I really want, but I know what you really want. I know that your daughter longs to be a human, out from under your thumb, but you long for something else, not just humanity, but the ability to perceive humanity. I have tried many times before, but with me, it will work. What do you propose? You know that my powers are cosmic, vast. Let's merge. I can bring with me, show you the universe. You can dimension hop. That is an interesting proposal. We'd share a body? Nah, it'd be more like we'd be a new person. Aware of what happened, but a completely new being. So they're gonna fuse like Steven Universe style. Oh, what should our name be? Oberquinn? Lord Keegan? Lord Quinn? Oberprime? Quinn Prime? Keegon? The possibilities are endless. I know, right? With my powers and your powers, we'd have all the powers.
Oh shit, they've merged. Well, I was really hoping for Oberon to be like, nah, I don't want to leave my daughter, but... Yep. He's a shit dad. Oh man, this is so cool. Oh, this is not good. Keegan Quinn merged with Oberon? What does that even mean? It means that we need to be cautious now. It means that we need to adjust our battle plans. What battle plans, Beth? We don't have battle plans. That's right, you don't. So my waifu squad is now the monster squad. How quaint. I enjoy a challenge. You will not win, fiend. Yeah, whatever. This affects things. I hope this does not affect date night. You're thinking of date night right now? A joke, Gan. I'm gonna go with Miranda. I'm gonna level my skill up, and I'm gonna ask her out. Miranda, would you like to go out, get your mind off this? On a date? Sure, just let me finish practice. We've got a bit left. Great, see you soon. I trust practice went well. You're an awesome skater. Why, thank you, and yes, it did. For the rest of the night, we eat and laugh. I do not bring up the rumors surrounding Arkham. Hey, wait up! Yes, Mr. Quinn? 3 months later. Oh? On God? Time skip? I know who you are now. No, you don't. Nobody knows me. You're Corion Atlantis, or Titus Andronicus. I'd say Macbeth, but we already have one. Anyhow, I figured that you're at least one of the fallen from grace generals that lie within the Shakespeare worlds. You know nothing. Except who you are. Hey, Fex, look what I can do. That's very clever, Mr. Quinn. Are you sassing me, robot? No, sir, I would never. That's good. Because I'm the coolest. Act 4, Battle of the World. Oh, shit. We're getting close to the end already? Damn, quick game. What is your opinion on that? It fucking sucks.
allows us to attain the unattainable. It allows us to literally leave the planet for the moon. I want my theater back.
Your theater?
Yui, time for you to go back into VR land and figure out how to stop Quinn from fucking our reality over. First, we have to make sure sexy Hamlet doesn't drive us mad. I want you to know, Kate, that I am the only doing the play as a favor to you. I know how much money your family lost in the war, and I only thought it's fair to help out the poor. Shut up, Tybalt! What's that, Tybalt? I couldn't hear you over your gigantic pot dick.
Ooh!
Wait, you just said that he has a big dick. That's not really an insult. You are extremely vulgar, child. See, it's when you smoke a lot of pot. I have no need for drugs. I get my kicks for free. Speak for yourself. I'll take the pot, then. Then you go limp. You can't get it up.
She's still explaining?
Oh, I should have gone out with Kate. Kate's a riot, but oh well. I like Miranda, too. I assure you, there is no problem down there. I'm going to be president one day, Kate. When that day comes, you will wish that you accepted my help instead of saying that I smoke illegal drugs. You will never be a king, Tybalt. That's because I will abolish the monarchy and make myself president of Elsinore. No, no, we got it. That was the implication. Once I attain my rightful power, then you will remember the day that Tybalt Capulet chose to partake in your play rather than be mean. So how do we get around sexy Hamlet? How do we make this play our play? Hey, at least we know that sexy Hamlet's bullshit is bullshit. That's the true silver lining here. Music theory? What is required most to make good music? You express that the one must study instruments. History? You come to class and read a note. I have trapped myself in a past time period using clues around campus to discover my location. Please do hurry, as this class activity may have been made in error. I'm guessing intelligence. You search for the clues and find them, then you go save Falstaff. Phys Ed! Nobody's here. From out of nowhere, ninjas attacking. They're also kicking dodgeballs. Flaming dodgeballs! Athletics. You protect your classmates from the dodgeballs, leaping out in front of each of you. You shrug off all the burns. Shot. Look, I don't know what it's like in there. Only you do. Just, I know. Be careful. Try to get information on what I still don't know. I'm serious. Someone in another dimension or whatnot is talking to me. Either that or one of you is fucking with me. Either way, just take a look. They start typing at the computer. What should we ask today? Defeat Quinn? You ask on how to defeat Keegan Quinn. They write back that life in general is weird. There are more things in heaven and earth, Buttercup. You think that sounds good, so you write that down. You instantly regret writing Buttercup. Caliban, I need to talk to you. What the? Caliban, you have to listen to me. I'm you, but from a different place. I know this is strict. Okay, we have human-isk Caliban. Now we have Dinosaur Caliban. This game is so fucking confusing, I swear. No, no. We've been talking to others? But you're a dinosaur and a cartoon? To me, you all look like cardboard cutouts. No, more like, I don't know. I'm not an expert on art styles. Are you who we've been talking to? I doubt it. Who are you? We don't have time. Caliban, Quinn is coming. Damn it! What's up? There's a third Caliban. I mean a second. What are you talking about? Apparently Quinn has not been to that universe yet, but then you showed up warning that Quinn was coming, but you were a dinosaur. Well, the system is fried. We can get back in. We're on our own with this. That sums it up. Great, so business as usual. Oh man, tonight's the play has to be a hit. You'll be fine, Kate. I mean, not a hit, but it needs to work. Theater's my life. To the quad! Let's kick this play into balls. We're gonna murder of Gazongo this thing. It'll be great. Oh, it's gonna be especially fun for Quinn. We're going to catch the conscience of a murderous intergalactic dictator. I say we put new fun stuff into play. Let's just say it's gonna be awesome. So, like, are you going to the cast party afterwards? I hope to see you there. Tomorrow may be the end of the world. We may only have a few moments left. Kate, I looked over the script changes that you made. This is a call to revolution. Sure, it's basically a retelling of the death of Hamlet Sr. and Hamlet Jr., but you also added stuff in about Quinn. If you are thinking of asking me if my goal is to get people to rebel after this play, you're right. There are more things in heaven and earth, Buttercup. That's odd. What is? That's the phrase that I use in the other universe. I hope that you picked the right combination of actors to inspire the audience. You're at least thankful that Sexy Hamlet decided to do the play in the afternoon when it isn't freezing out. Everyone, please take your seats. The play is starting. As soon as Fex finishes their sentence, the play begins. First few scenes go well. The audience is moved to see even a fakery of a ghost of their long-dead King Hamlet. A little more than kin and less than kind, Sexy Hamlet starts his rendition of playing himself. He's playing himself. The audience is entranced. You're pretty sure it's because of this glistening chest. You're damn right it is! Time for Ophelia. My lord, as I was sewing in my closet, Lord Hamlet, with his doubled all embrace, no hat upon his head, his stockings fold and guarded and down his ankles. Pale as a shirt, his knees knocking each other, and with a look so piteous in purport, as if he had been loosed out of hell to speak of horrors, he comes before me. It finally comes to the big church scene. Claudius is going to pray, and Hamlet has a chance to strike his fall down. This is a crucial scene. Oh, my offense is rank. It smells to heaven. It hath the primal elder's curse upon it. It's still fucking funny that he's just a fucking stick figure now. I keep forgetting that he's a stick figure. Also, I don't know how he, like, decided to go along with this. I guess just because he doesn't want Quinn to do whatever else to him, but whatever, man. Good on you, Claudius, for being a good sport. A brother's murder. Audience gasps at this. Praise can I not. Though inclination be as sharp as will, my stronger guilt defeats my strong intent. Claudius is actually crying. The play progresses to its end. The rest is silence. The audience is incensed. Some stands up again yelling for blood. Others yell traitors. One thing is clear. The house is getting rowdy. Rebellion! Now everyone settle down. Anger levels rising. We should leave. I am getting out of here. Let's go to town. Oh, damn. Look at my scores for Miranda. And for second, we have Puck. And for third, we have Othello, Gan, and Kate. So, let's go see what Puck's up to. Want to go to the derby? Sure. Caliban. Okay. I'm a coach on the old days of the week. For Miranda's crew? No, even though I'd like to keep more of an eye on her than she wants, Prospero's spies are everywhere. Even in friendly nations, one slip up from Miranda and all three of us are screwed. No, I coach the freshman skaters. Any rising talent? Henry the fourth kid has some pretty nice skills. Needs to get his head out of the clouds, though. I'll get through to him. What about your electronics work? Oh, you mean my Richard line? Richard line? Oh yeah, the entire reason why Cal got a teaching job was because of his work with his robotic AI dinosaurs. Wait, what? How come I never heard about this? We kind of keep it under wraps. Only a few people know. Now you do too. Thanks, Puck. You're welcome. Does everyone know my secret identity now? Yep. Great. Richard II is a Baronix. That was a medium-sized theropod. Anyway, he's been giving me trouble recently. His AI keeps lagging and making him unable to make actual decisions. So to answer your question, I'm still working on my stuff, but not as much. This is your distraction. Exactly. Puck and I skate. Relationship with Puck is gaining a level. Thanks for hanging out with me today. Anytime, Puck. I'll level up my skill. Bye, Puck. Alright, let's hang out with Kate. So, something I've always been meaning to ask. What is your family's deal? Miranda's from the Kingdom of Arkham. Puck is the kid of the Fae Kid. But what is the story behind Kate and Nantucket? My sister died in the war. Wait, what? Kate, I'm so sorry. Thanks. Bianca, she was my dad's favorite. He wanted nothing but the best for us. We were supposed to go to Elsinore Academy together. I was supposed to protect her. I was always more aggressive than two. Bianca was naive. Then she enlisted. I don't know what to say. Don't say anything. You didn't know. It is honestly not something I discuss much. I stopped becoming fun, curse word Kate, when people learned that. How many people have you told? Not many. Now you, like I said, people will look at me differently. They think, well, accurately, that my attitude is in response to her death. It definitely amplified it. Kate, I know that your support system is vast, but if you ever need to talk, I'm here. God, now I kind of regret going down Miranda's route. I really like Kate. She's fucking great. Thank you, Evie. Alright, let's go talk to Viola. I think that I can bring Cleopatra back from whatever fae prison that she is currently in. Have you found her? Her life signs are weak, but she's still on this plane. She's currently surrounded by fae magic, though. It's nice to see you using your phenomenal cosmic powers for good. I'm going to get started right away. Man, oh man, I hope that I can get enough fresh pig blood. Like, it has to be super fresh. So you're gonna be murdering pigs instantly. Got it. And I gained a level with her. Alright, let's go to Cheese's Crust. Othello! Level up. You have decided. Upon what? I am 50% on not signing back up with the military. Is that an option? Once you're in, I thought you were in for life. Even tangentially. I can't fucking read! I do appreciate you looking out for me. I'm trying to learn the ropes, as it were. But I will deal with whatever I need to as it comes. I always have. It is how I work. It is what I know best. Level up. Boop. See you later, Othello. Let's go talk to Macbeth. Hey. So I started going to therapy. I think that's fantastic. I'm happy for you, Macbeth. Thank you. I assume that I'll eventually build up to talking to Viola, but that's not now. Okay, I can't level up my skill. Yeah, looks like my skill's gonna be pretty low for Macbeth, but I'm not really interested in him. Tegan! No! Shit! I didn't mean to do that! Fuck! No! Oh, no! Great, I guess I gotta go to the cast party with Gan and not Miranda. Shit. Hope that doesn't fuck it up. It's really nice of your uncle to let us use your house for the cast party. Yeah, I bet it would pop into his head. However, that was a giant countrywide rebellion would start tonight. We had the whole house to ourselves. Hey, Gan, great party. Why are you being nice? Because I've been looting all the silverware. Is Tybalt smiling? He's stealing. Makes sense. He did it! You brought an entire ruling structure to its knees. How's it feel? It feels like it's gonna be fun until a war starts. So, second thoughts? No, I always knew it wouldn't be easy. I just did not know that Elsinore was this much of a powder keg. Things are gonna get weird, hero. Peace always comes at a price. You have all been very naughty. Dangerous for you to be here, Quinn. Lots of people want you and the rest of the upper crust dead. Oh, and you will think you can kill me? Maybe normal people can't kill you. Maybe normal weapons can't harm you. You're serious? Get out of here, Kate. You're serious? I'm both an interdimensional Eldritch Horror and a Fairy King. We're not scared of you. We're not scared of you, are we? No. By now, the crowd of thespians and partygoers has figured out what is about to go down. A wide circle of drunks and rabble-rousers begins to form. Encasing the mages, people slowly begin chanting the Elsinore Tigers fight song. Miranda, you gave up magic. Viola, you're trying to give it up. Sacrifices need to be made for the greater good. So be it. Suddenly, time and space seem to... slow? Where are we? My turf. Well, now this is an even fight. Robin Puck, how nice of you to join us. I must say that I'm in no mood to kill any potential merchandise, but you are really pushing my hand. What even are you? My name is Legion, but like, you know, not actually Legion. I am called Keegan Quinn, I am called the Destroyer, I am called the Doom that came, I am called Death, I am called Cannon, sometimes the Cannon, which is much cooler, I think, with that little the. I am your Doom. I wish that I could describe the battle. I really do. But seems at the limit of my imagination. You could say my imagination's budget was far too small for the scope of what happened next. It was really cool, though. Lots of flashing lights. Really wish that I had a bigger, let's say, budget on my imagination. Or in this game. What just happened? That was a blur. Did we win? We all look around us. The entire circle is knocked out cold. Eventually, some began to slowly get up. One groggy picks up a steaming pile of what we can identify as Keegan Quinn's odd clothing. Quinn is gone. On God? For real? Huh. Okay, give me a second, give me a second. There's something I need to do.
That was easy.
It was indeed easy. We won! Yay! The crowd, the ones that are up, start instinctually yelling and clapping. I am plumb dumb with magic. It's dance time! Yay? Yay! It's dance time, fam! I am hungry as shit. I'm getting food. Seconded. So who do I dance with at the cast party? I mean, like, dance. Like, I mean it. Miranda. They say sure. Relationship with Miranda has gained a level. You dance the night away like you mean it. Eventually, everyone leaves for their dorms. Dear me, I am pooped. You know, it was odd, but I really enjoyed the VR simulations that we have had to do in class. I thought they were way too weird. Yeah, they just seemed really obscure. 3 weeks later. Another time skip? We're going to be late. Let's not dilly-dally. It's the official rebellion kickoff dance. We need to spruce up the gym. I didn't get us all out of class for nothing. Is it really going to be called that? Well, no. The destroy the monarchy didn't sound quite right. Neither did destroy the school or destroy the establishment. Fair. It's going to be so much fun. Epilogue. Oh, we get to do a dance with everyone. Viola, why are we flying the state's colors? Well, that's easy to tear them down. You are growing on me. Viola, I don't really feel like dressing up tonight. We just went through battle. Yui's right. We're all poop. Can't we just, you know, come in regular clothes? That's the plan. It's a rebellion. Awesome. I still expect you both to cheer on Othello and Macbeth as they lead us to victory tonight. Sure thing. Metaphorical and literal victory. Also, double literal victory. The night came, the football game came, the Elsinore Tigers ended up losing, but that didn't matter. We all had fun welcoming in the beginning of the end, and the beginning of the rest of our lives. Welcome to the party, Yui. Everyone already tore down all the good stuff. Sorry, but if you want, they are busy tearing down Claudia's statue in the quad. Thank you, Viola. I think I'm gonna go mill around a bit. Awesome! Don't be a wallflower. So who do I dance with? I think we all know who I'm gonna dance with. Would you like to dance? Of course! We dance. So, really leaving back to Arkham? I assume that my dad will call me back, yeah. Why don't you say no? You know the answer to that. I can't. I went to Elsinore. My fate was sealed long ago. The political landscape is fucked up beyond recognition. And most that I can do is try to change that. That's all we can hope for, I guess. Want to get out of here? Lead on. A woman will have her will. You and your beloved sneak your way back into the gym, adjusting your clothes as needed. Oh. Oh, did we fuck? Y'all, I think I just banged a fucking furry. Hey, we're all gonna get out of here. We're meeting on the football field for one last hurrah. I'll be there. Okay, don't be long. It's kind of cold outside and we're trying to take a picture. This is our last night. I know that some of you want to get back to the party, but you all mean the world to me. And given how we are bound to be shipped back to our home countries or territories in the coming days, I'd like to say that I love each and every one of you. Well, due to the rebellion, who knows what will happen. But I see your point. A lot of us will be shipped back to our homes for general safety. We are mostly still royal heirs, after all. This has been quite the year. We defeated a monster. Okay, stay with me here. What if Keegan Quinn was part of the VR test? Then that's some pretty fucked up test. I mean, regardless, the test was still pretty fucked up. True, I just don't see it, though. Too much actual stuff happened. Yeah, and what about the stuff with my dad? It is simply a theory. Either way, I'm glad that it is over. Like Othello said, you're my family. Nothing is gonna take that from me. Not my father, not anyone. How will it be going back to Arkham Island? I'll survive. I always have. It'll be super weird, though. I have not been home in years. I'm not human, I'm Fae. It took me a long time to come to terms with this. With you, but you all have taught me to be human, and that's why I was sent here in the first place. Thank you. Yay, friends! I'll keep this short. None of you better die, ever. Or else I'll kill you. So you're gonna kill me if I die? I respect that, Kate. I was taken from my father, taken from my world, in a land where I was to be uncomfortable my entire life. You all made me comfortable. Aw, again? You all, in no uncertain terms, saved my life. I freaking love Gan. I can't believe I'm saying this, but Kate stole what I was going to say. Of course the tone was supposed to be different, but I love y'all. Well, tomorrow's tomorrow. Tonight is tonight. We all made the night a good one. As I was walking to the dorms, I thought about what tomorrow would bring. Tears, goodbyes, new beginnings. Oh, hi! But we defeated you. Friend, I'm like if Oberon and Keegan Quinn had a baby and it was me. I'll find a way to stop you. We all will. You all will? The Monster Squad? Please, they show how much potential. But I was never here because of them. I have you to thank for finding them for me, though. What do you mean? You looked in the VR headset. You know already. No, I don't. My mind was racing. How do we stop this monster? Your narration needs work. What? You're mixing tenses. You keep messing up your tenses. Not to mention swapping first and third person all the time. And it is so annoying. What are you talking about? Don't worry. You'll learn someday. You two won't get away with this. Maybe Fix has a glitch, Keegan. Do you really think that the Chosen One would butcher language on a Shakespeare planet of all places? I'm fine, Hamlet. You can go. Do you think that it is coincidence that you could communicate with them or that your textbooks are the same color? My text? What do you mean? Oh, never mind. Don't worry about it. To you, it's not important. Am I? From there?
What did you twist?
Yes and no. Am I the beacon that drew you here? That's complicated. You're one of the beacons, you see. You're what I'd call a chosen one. Each dimension has one, and they all exhibit unique properties. But you're an evolutionary marvel. You're one out of 50 gazillion. Start making sense. You're the only one that can communicate with the other Shakespeare dimensions. Maybe even any other dimension. Oh, that would be so cool if it was true. You see, I can only point myself towards the beacons. I don't get to pick where I go. It's kind of a drag on my main plot. I thought absorbing Oberon would allow me your power, but no. I'll never help you. You have no choice, kid. Time to pack your things. You've got places to be. I just said I'll never help you with your weird interdimensional galactic conquest. I heard that. Fine, let's do it this way. Come with me, or this entire planet becomes a cardboard cutout. Shit, I can't save. Alright, we're gonna be doing a coin flick on what we're gonna be doing. Heads, we help Quinn. Tails, we don't help Quinn. Heads, we help Quinn. Alright. Do I have your word? Normally I'm evil and such, but this time, yes, you do. Okay. That's a good protagonist. The tale ends here. If we have offended, then play again and try a different route. But for now, please accept our humble epilogues. My dad was gone, out of my life. I wonder if this is how humans feel when their parents die. We continue to just completely dominate Verona Academy for the next remaining season. They didn't win one game. I never forgot my friendship with Yui. Wherever they ended up, I led our roller derby group to the Olympics. There's no roller derby group in the Olympics, but whatever. I eventually dropped out of school. Dropping out was as a senior. Yeah, I get it. Oh, it's my turn to do the epilogue thing now. I get to do Puck's thing. I get to talk to no one. Yay! I resurrected Cleopatra and we had a zombie head cheerleader for a while. Eventually I had to put her down for obvious zombie-related reasons. Kate and I founded a theater group as we focus on political plays. We want to change things in art and in the world. Our pen name is Shakespeare. Ah! I see. I continued to do the theater. Broadway shop ruined the day that I walked the streets. Country of Elsinor on the continent of Arden on the planet Earth was in open rebellion. Change was coming. We all only hoped that it wouldn't hurt that much. Alright. We did it. We beat the game. Alright. Honestly, I did not really expect to beat this game so quickly, but yeah. Well, this was an interesting game. Yeah, there's like... Oh shit, hang on, there's more. Perhaps it was not the best decision in the world. Keegan Quinn will return in Furry Shakespeare 2, if that ever gets made. I think that was already made, but I don't know if we'll play that. Oh, yep, okay, yep, now we're done, okay. Well, that was something. I can tell that they put, like, a lot of love in this game, but I don't know if I'll, like, play the second game. It didn't really interest me too much. There was, like, a lot to take in. I guess, like, I didn't play the right game or something. I don't know. But, yeah, we beat it. I did like the character designs and, like, stuff like that. But I wish there was, like, more, like, character art and stuff like that. I don't know. I'm just rambling at this point.